The cops investigating this crime should have a relay station set up. It'll look like a mobile satellite dish, probably on a rooftop. Disadvantage if I can't tap into the cops' communications. I should hack their mobile relay station.
Rubio, what's your 20?
On the balcony for a smoke with a menace.
Those men on the balcony, that could be my way in.
Open and shut, Case.
Stubby little fingerprints right by the bodies.
Yeah, we got Penguin now. Like to see him squirm out of this one.
Fingerprints, two dead bodies. He's about to do some time.
Yeah, except forensics will take all the credit. And I'm the one who found the prints.
That's why they call it first response. First pickings on the loot, but none of the glory.
Execute!
Police believe Penguin murdered Black Mask. But why would he send me here if he was the killer? It doesn't add up. This crime took place days ago. The fire and the exposure to the elements make identifying the victims difficult. The male victim is wearing a black mask, but I can't positively identify him as Roman Sionis without a DNA analysis. Something I can't do in the field. I can identify the female victim based on her fingerprints. Tiffany Ambrose, Roman Sionis' girlfriend. Or one of them, at least. She was no angel. Long list of priors. But nothing to indicate she was the target here. The fire spread as a result of a Molotov cocktail thrown into the room. It may have been intended to destroy evidence. The shallow trajectory of the bullet suggests the shooter could be someone of Penguin's height. But the grooves on the floor suggest that the victim was killed by someone leaning back in a chair. This bullet was fired from a revolver. Ballistics analysis indicates a low angle of trajectory. The shooter could have been someone of Penguin's height. But the pattern in the gunpowder residue suggests the bullet was actually fired by someone lying on the ground. Jim's fingerprints are a match for the Penguin, but they're on top of the soot from the fire. The cops were right. Penguin was in the room, but these prints prove he was here after the murders were committed. If he didn't kill Black Mask, who did? The only thing I know for certain is that Tiffany's shooter was lying on the floor. But why? These white streaks are shoe polish. Whoever shot Tiffany was being dragged along the floor. Besides the victims, there were two other people in the room. Tiffany's shooter, and whoever was dragging the shooter. The location from which the male victim was shot may tell me more. The DNA here doesn't belong to either of the victims. Whose is it? The fight broke out when someone startled the shooter. It's not clear who won the fight. It could have been either one of them. I should review the evidence to see if I can learn anything more about either the intruder or the shooter. Fabric analysis indicates the intruder was wearing a white suit or sport jacket. This fabric swatch could help identify the intruder, but I still can't identify the male victim's shooter. There's one impact area I haven't checked for clues. This DNA is from the female victim. The level of oxidation suggests it's been here for several days. If I review the evidence, I may be able to find out what she was doing when she was attacked. She was sending text messages to Roman Sionis about someone named the Joker. Someone killed Black Mask, but this crime took place several days ago, and I saw Black Mask earlier tonight. The only answers I have raise more questions. Who is the Joker? Was he the killer here, or is he one of the assassins? I have a body. An unknown shooter, and an unknown assailant who attacked the shooter. I need to match the DNA samples against the records in the National Criminal Database to identify who was in the room. Alfred, I need access to the National Criminal Database.
Well, the only way to do that would be to infiltrate the Gotham City Police Department.
Then that's where I'm going.
Sir, you'd need to physically hack into their servers. If you insist on doing something that foolish, you'll need a powerful, non-lethal weapon. I recommend coming back here to pick up your concussion detonator.
Not a bad idea.
Welcome home, sir. The concussion detonator is on your workbench. Remember, if you use that instead of your fists, you'll do less lasting damage to those police officers and civil servants.
Noted.
Well played, sir. You stopped the electrocutioner with a single strike.
I just used his arrogance to my advantage. A textbook move a child could have avoided.
True, but I doubt the rest of them will go down as easily.
If they do, we'll be eating that Christmas ham sooner than you think.
Doubled at police precincts since Loeb's murder. You'll need to find a way to sneak in that won't attract attention. Otherwise, you'll never make...
Understood. Thanks.
Yeah, probably another water pipe bursting. Love to go take a look, but, you know, my shift's over. Low.
This won't be easy, but if I'm going to access the National Criminal Database and find out what happened at Lacey Towers, I need to find the server room without being discovered.
Competing for a huge bounty, which Black Mask has offered for the head of the Bat.
Where do I sign up?
I thought he was a ghost.
All right, cut the chatter, people.
Yeah, well, they were surprised.
Must you be so brutal, sir? These are city employees.
They're as corrupt as they come, and they're in my way.
I wish you'd think twice about that approach, sir. You never know when you might need their help. At any rate, your objective is the GCPD server room. I marked it on your map.
Serve some more.
Built what else?
261 line 7, please. Delta 61 line 7.
Don't stand a chance against that many armed men. I can use Deathstroke's remote claw to pass above their heads undetected.
All right, listen up. While you jokers were playing cleanup for a slack day, I was making us some money. I've worked out a deal with our pal Black Mask. If any of us can kill him before the assassins get to him, we get...
If I'm not careful, that guard will alert the others.
Scumbag. If we can't find dirt, we make our own. What if Captain Gordon allowed all the perps in the holding cells to go free?
You mean we set loose?
Mission here from Central. They're offering a reward of 25.
Just get him down!
You're just another.
So what does this disruptor of yours do?
Little bit of this, little bit of that. Mostly, though, it does a whole lot of none of your damn business.
Not you again!
Talk, or you won't be walking anywhere, ever.
No way! You gotta answer for dropping me off that rooftop, buddy!
No, you have to answer to me. How does this disruptor work?
Ask one of the pigs! They got it in evidence lockup!
How about we take a little walk up to the roof?
Okay. Okay, you win! It jams weapons, overrides electronic locks, all right? Now you gotta let me go!
How'd that work out for you last time?
Gonna wipe things clean, he should start with you.
Good one.
This'll help.
premises. Repeat, priority one alert. Intruder in the building.
Get yourself to a shelter.
You kidding? That's where they round us up. You don't get it. Anarchy gets it, but you? You don't get it, man.
Are you listening to me? I don't care what's going on out there. I gotta deal with this problem. If I don't give this bastard what he wants, he'll sip.
Are justified, who acts completely outside the system.
The system is broken.
Barbara, wait.
There's 50 million bucks riding on this, so I don't want to hear any excuses. Bag the bat and let's get paid.
Could be I've lost my passion for this line of work.
researching your quadrant?
I'll leave that for the boys in SWAT.
Why's that?
Ain't you heard? Brandon made a deal with Black Mask.
You're racking up time!
Priority 1 alert. All personnel, report to your department head. Need a head count. A lot of people unaccounted for.
Using a security protocol I'm not familiar with, and the windows are reinforced glass. The disruptor in the evidence locker might do the trick. The evidence locker. I need an alternate route.
The evidence locker, sir? Well, according to these schematics, it adjoins an old elevator shaft which you can access via the infirmary. You should be able to break in from there. I've added it to your map.
Turn it in.
Good, you've made it to the infirmary. Now look for an entrance to an old elevator shaft. That will take you to the evidence locker.
Got it.
Thank you.
should be able to bypass the security on the server room door.
I got a pulse.
All right, call it in. Let's get him to Gotham General.
Will do. As soon as he stabilizes.
I need access to the National Criminal Database.
It's right here.
You must spend a lot of time here.
Cool poem box. You're bypassing the network security. But you'll need to physically bridge the intranet to the external telecom wires if you want to uplink remotely.
This kind of knowledge could get a young girl into a lot of trouble.
They run under the building.
What does?
The telecom wires. You can access them through the sewers. Wait. Why do you do what you do?
Because I made a promise.
Get out of here!
Alfred, I'm on my way out. Before I can access the server remotely, I need to hack into the telecom wires under the GCPD.
You should be able to access them from the sewers which run below the building. I'll peg the closest entrance on your map.
Sir, they say the bat doesn't have a gun.
Penguin's man said the disruptor can be used to jam their weapons.
Dispatch on the horn!
I don't want to hurt you, but you need to stay out of my way.
Never.
Listen, I'm on your side.
My side? My side works within the law. My side doesn't leave suspects with broken bones and missing teeth. We've earned Gotham's respect.
If that were true, I wouldn't believe you.
Gordon, clear the line of fire!
Hold your fire! If he moves, take him down.
You've got nowhere to run.
Move, Gordon! I'm taking him down!
Ugh.